Good morning, my dear students. So coming to advantages of power electronic converters. So what are the advantages of power electronic converters means here? So first one is higher efficiency due to low loss. Okay, higher efficiency due to low loss in power semiconductor devices. That means whatever may be the outputs, okay, whatever may be the outputs, we can get the more output. So that's why automatically efficiency will be high. And next, high reliability of power electronic converter systems. High reliability, what do you mean by reliability? Reliability is nothing but here whatever may be the device, it should withstand according to its ratings. That means it should perform its operation very effectively based upon the specifications. So that is nothing but high reliability. Next, long life and less maintenance. Of course, these devices are, if there will be no moving parts in the power electronic converters, so that's why these will be having the long life and less maintenance. And next one is fast dynamic response. Fast dynamic response, that means whenever if you are comparing with the electromechanical converter systems, these systems will be having the fast dynamic response. And next, last one is small size and less weight. That means here you are not using any moving parts. You are using only static parts, which are nothing but very small sizes. So that's why here the small size and less weight results in less floor space. That means these will occupy less floor space. And of course, installation cost. Okay, of course, installation cost will be also less. Okay, installation cost will be also less. That means here first one, fatafat, high efficiency will be high, and next, reliability will be high, and longer life and less maintenance will be there, and dynamic response will be fast, and small size and less weight, and cost will be also decreased. Next one, coming to the disadvantages of the power electronic converters. Okay, coming to disadvantages of the power electronic converters. What are the disadvantages? So in general, all these are sometimes we may get harmonics. Okay, sometimes we may get harmonics in the supply system as well as in the load circuit. Okay, supply system as well as in the load system. So that's why these power electronic converter circuits have a tendency to generate harmonics in the supply system. And the next one is here, low power factor operation. Okay, coming to next one is low power factor operation. That means AC to DC and AC to AC converters operate at low power factor under the certain operating conditions. In order to avoid this low power factor, we need to take some special measures. Okay, some special measures we need to take for low power factor operation. And next, low overload capacity. All these power electronic converters, okay, all these power electronic converters will be having the low overload capacity. And of course, these converters must therefore be rated for taking momentary overloads. As such, cost will be also increased. Okay, sometimes cost will be also, which one power converters, cost of the power train controllers will be increases. Okay, please remember that in the advantages, cost is decreasing. Okay, only power converters, but here power electronic controller we are using. Okay, so the controlling costs will be increased. Next one, regeneration of power is difficult. Okay, in the power electronic converter systems, the regeneration of the power is somewhat difficult. Next one, power electronic systems. In the power electronic systems, here we can go for the output, whatever may be here, by means of seeing the black diagram of power electronic system. The main components, okay, main components, you can see main source will be there. Source may be either AC supply system, source may be either AC supply system or DC supply system. Okay, main source will be AC supply system or DC supply system. And of course, here output from the power electronic circuit may be, okay, output means here the load, this output will be the, that output may be AC or DC, okay, AC or DC or variable DC or AC voltage. Okay, it may be a variable voltage and frequency also you can get. So that means the output of the power electronic converter circuit depends upon the requirement of the load. That means the output of the power electronic converter circuit depends upon the requirements of the load. Suppose if you are taking one example, if the load is a DC motor, okay, if the load is a DC motor, the converter output, okay, the converter output, what should be the converter output? The converter output should be or must be adjustable direct voltage, okay, adjustable direct voltage or DC voltage, okay, adjustable direct voltage or DC voltage, if the load is a DC motor. Suppose if the load is a three phase induction motor, okay, if the load is a three phase induction motor, then the converter may have adjustable voltage and frequency, okay, the converter may have adjustable voltage and frequency at its output terminals. That means here at the output, what should be there? If the load is a DC motor, then automatically it should be adjustable DC voltage should be there. And next, if the load is a three phase induction motor, then what would be the output? Output should be voltage and frequency adjustable. Okay, converter may have adjustable voltage and frequency at the output terminals. Next one. Coming to feedback. Here, he has given the feedback. That means whenever you are taking the speed, assume that whenever you are taking the speed as a feedback, then it will compare with the command. Okay, then it will compare, that feedback signal will be compared with the command. Okay, with the command. The difference of these two, okay, the difference of the feedback signal and command signal with respect to speed will be again applicable for this digital circuit components. These will controls the instant of the turn on of the semiconductor device forming the solid state power converter system. That means whatever may be the this difference will be applicable for this digital circuit, and that will be goes to power electronic circuit, and that will be goes to this load. This is the black diagram explanation of the typical power electronic circuits. Next, types of the power converters. Okay, types of the power converters. What are the some types of the power converters are there in general? What are those means? So first one is diode rectifier. Okay, first one is a diode rectifier. What is mean by diode rectifier? It's nothing but a rectifier circuit convert AC. Okay, convert AC input voltage into fixed DC voltage. Please remember that AC input voltage to fixed DC voltage. Of course, the input may be, what is meant by AC here? Input may be single phase supply or three phase supply. Okay, input may be a single phase supply or three phase supply. What are the applications? Okay, what are the applications are using? Okay, what are the using of this diode rectifier means, where we will use this diode rectifier means, first one is electric traction. First one is electric traction. In the case of the electric traction purpose, we will use. And next, coming to battery charging. Coming to battery charging, and next electroplating, and next electroplating, and next electrochemical process in the case of the electrochemical process, and next power supplies. In case of power supplies also we will use, and in case of welding, okay, in case of welding we might have seen in outside welding, and of course in the UPS, uninterruptible power supplies. That means where we will use this diode rectifier. What do you mean by first of all diode rectifier? Means which converts, it is a rectifier circuit which converts AC input voltage to fixed DC voltage, and of course the input may be single phase or three phase. Where we will use in the case of the electric traction, battery charging, and electroplating, electrochemical processes, and power supplies, and of course welding, and uninterruptible power supply system. Next, AC to DC converters. Next, we are discussing types of the power electronic converters. What are those power electronic converters? Means first one is diode rectifier. The second one is AC to DC converters. AC to DC converters can also be called as phase controlled rectifiers. AC to DC converters can also be called as phase controlled rectifiers. So what is mean by this one? Means these converts constant, okay, these converts constant AC voltage, constant AC voltage to variable, okay, constant voltage to variable DC voltage, okay, variable DC output voltage. Just remember that in the case of the diode rectifier, AC input voltage to fixed DC voltage we have conversion, but here in the case of the AC to DC converters, which are nothing but phase controlled rectifiers, these convert constant AC voltage to variable DC output voltage. Okay, that means here whatever may be the constant AC voltage, which is nothing but variable DC, it will be DC, but it may be varying. Okay, it may be varying. In which way we will see in the later classes. Okay. So, and of course, what are the applications? Okay, where we will use means here, in the case of the DC drives, okay, in the case of the DC drives and chemical industries, and chemical industries, metallurgical industries, chemical industries, metallurgical industries, and excitation systems, okay, excitation systems. This excitation system will be useful for synchronous machines. Please be remember that. So where we will use this AC to DC converter means examples are DC drives, and next metallurgical and chemical industries, and excitation systems for synchronous machines. That is the AC to DC converter. First one, diode rectifier, means AC input voltage to fixed DC voltage conversion. AC to DC converters are constant AC to variable DC. And next, DC to DC converters, okay, DC to DC converters are, this can also be called as DC choppers. Please be remember that this can also be called as DC choppers. A DC, what is mean by DC chopper? Means simply these will convert fixed, okay, these will convert fixed DC input voltage to controllable DC output, okay, controllable DC output voltage. Okay, DC to DC converters or DC choppers, what is mean by this one? Means these converts fixed DC input voltage to a controllable DC output voltage, fixed DC to controllable DC output voltage. Please remember this one. DC to DC choppers, DC to DC converters are fixed DC to controllable DC output voltage. Where we will use this one? applications are, of course, these can also be used in DC drives. And next, subway cars. DC drives, subway cars, and trolley trucks, and next, battery driven vehicles. Okay, battery driven vehicles, where we will use all these things: DC drives, subway cars, trolley trucks, and battery driven vehicles. All these will be used. So once again, I am repeating, diode rectifier means which converts AC input voltage into fixed DC voltage. AC to DC converters are nothing but which converts AC voltage to variable DC output voltage. And DC to DC converters are, which are nothing but DC choppers, which converts fixed DC input voltage to a controllable DC output voltage. That you need to remember. Next one, DC to AC converters, which are nothing but, these can also be called as inverters. So this is also one of the type of power electronic converter. What is meant by this one means, an inverter convert fixed DC voltage to variable AC voltage. Okay, fixed DC voltage to variable AC voltage. Okay, variable AC voltage. DC to AC converters means fixed DC voltage to variable AC voltage. So here output may be have, that means variable AC voltage. AC voltage will be having the two quantities, which are nothing but voltage and frequency. So here it may be a variable voltage. Okay, it may be a variable voltage and variable frequency. Please remember this one. And next, where we will use means, here these may be used in induction motor and synchronous motor drives, induction motors and synchronous motor drives. And next, induction heating, and of course UPS, HVDC transmission also we will use. Okay, please remember all these applications. Once again, am I repeating, diode rectifier means which converts AC input voltage to fixed DC voltage. AC to DC converters means phase control rectifiers constant AC voltage to variable DC output voltage. DC to DC converters or DC choppers means which converts fixed DC input voltage to controllable DC output voltage. DC to AC converters are, which are nothing but inverters, which converts fixed DC voltage to a variable AC voltage. Next one is AC to AC converters. Okay, AC to AC converters. These convert fixed AC input voltage. Okay, fixed AC input voltage to variable AC output voltage. Okay, please remember this one. Fixed AC input voltage to variable AC output voltage. So of course there may be of two types. The first one is AC voltage controller. Which are nothing but AC voltage regulator also. That means these converts AC voltage controller. Okay, AC voltage controller converts fixed. Okay, converts fixed AC voltage to directly variable AC voltage. Okay, fixed AC to variable AC voltage, but frequency at the same frequency. Please remember this one. Frequency is same. And next, frequency is same, please remember this one. What are the application where we will use? In the case of the lighting control, in the case of the lighting control, and next, speed control of fans. Speed control of fans, speed control of fans, our general in domestic we are using the fans now. There that is nothing but AC voltage controller things. And next, pumps, in case of pumps, okay, in case of pumps. Once again I am repeating, AC to AC converters, these converts fixed AC input voltage to variable AC output voltage. In the AC to AC converters, there will be of two types, AC voltage controllers and cyclo converters. AC voltage controllers are AC voltage regulators. These converts fixed AC voltage to variable AC voltage, but should be at same frequency. These are where we will use lighting and speed control of fans, and next, pumps we will use. Please remember this one. Next, coming to cyclo converters. What are the cyclo converters? These cyclo converters convert input power, okay, convert input power at one frequency, input power at one frequency, input power at one frequency to the output power, okay, input power at one frequency to the output power at different frequency, okay, output power at different frequency, output power at different frequency through one stage conversion, okay, through one stage conversion. What are the way we will use means here, slow speed large AC drives, okay, slow speed large AC drives. In case of slow speed large AC drives, like rotary kiln, okay, like rotary kiln we will use, okay, like rotary kiln we will use slow speed large AC drives. In case of slow speed large AC drives we will use. So once again I am repeating, AC to AC converters are of the, what is mean by that one means AC, which converts AC input voltage into variable AC output voltage. There will be of two types, one is AC voltage controller and other one is cyclo converters. AC voltage controllers, which converts fixed AC voltage fixed AC voltage directly to the variable AC voltage at same frequency. AC voltage controller will convert fixed AC voltage directly to the variable AC voltage at same frequency. And cyclo converters, what I mean by cyclo converters, these converts input power at one frequency to the output power at a different frequency. Okay, these are the types of the power converters. And the next one is static switches. Okay, static switches are there. These are static switches are nothing but in general power semiconductor devices are power, can be operated as a static switches. Okay, and next, depending upon the input supply, these static switches are called AC switches and DC static switches will be there.